Why do we fall at even? Silhouettes for the evening. Might just be my time, and I know just what you like, but I'm still fucked up. Yeah, still fucked up.
Getting around 100 is something every single Zombies player has aspired ever since they were a little boy. The first time you pick up that controller, your goal is to get to the highest round possible, and everybody thought if you were able to see 3 digits on your screen that you were a beast. Now once you actually achieve this goal, getting those double digits to turn into 3 digits, especially for the first time, is a remarkable feeling. Now some players take it to the next level and they speedrun round 100 as fast as they possibly can. Something that might take a normal person hours or even days takes a speedrunner just an hour or two. Today, we are looking at the fastest round 100 ever achieved on Black Ops 3 Zombies by Ganon Snipe. Now we're all wondering, what the hell did Ganon do that made him so fast? Did he train in the spawn room like most BO1 players do? Maybe he even trained in Biodome. Maybe he even trained on Mule Kick right next to the teleporter. He actually did none of that, and he went straight into Tunnel 11 and camped the whole entire time. How can Ganon just stay in Tunnel 11 without moving at all? Obviously, you know, ammo was gonna be a problem. How the hell is he gonna be able to get his ammo back when he's gone? Well, my friends, he used Mega Gobblegums. Mega Gobblegums are super OP Gobblegums that basically allow you to do whatever the hell you want. So as soon as you spawn in on No Man's Land, you're going straight to the Gobblegum machine, and you're restarting for Raindrops. Raindrops is crucial for every single star of every speedrun, mainly because it gives you a lot of points. It allows you to nuke out the first round, which will let you be faster. And in this case, it'll let you hit the box. Now, the really sucky thing about Moon is there's really bad RNG involving the mystery box. Now, you need Gersh's and the wave gun in your first, like, 4 to 8 hits. If you don't get Gersh's and wave gun in your first, like, 8 hits, then the world record is not going to be able to be achieved. It's going to be simply too slow. So if you watch Ganon, you'll see he restarts over and over again until he's able to get those two things in the first box. Now, once this round finishes, he's going to haul ass all the way to Tunnel 11. He's going to play fast over there. Now, all Ganon is doing is literally shooting at these two spawns. He's shooting at the left spawn. He's shooting at the right spawn. And as soon as he finishes, he's going to go straight to Pack-a-Punch. Now, you might wonder, why is Ganon going to Pack-a-Punch on round 5? And also, why is he not turning on power? Don't you want to turn on power instantly? I'll answer those two questions for you very simply right now. On Moon, every time you go to Pack-a-Punch, the game has a little glitch or bugs out, you might want to call it. When you teleport to Pack-a-Punch, the game thinks you're advancing one round. So say you're on round 5, when you teleport to Pack-a-Punch, the game thinks you just finished that round, so now it's round 6. And then when you teleport back from Pack-a-Punch, the game thinks you advanced another round, so now it's round 7. But in reality, you never advanced any round. So every time you go to Pack-a-Punch, your zombie spawn rate actually increases by 2 rounds. So say he goes on round 5, as you saw he did right now. The game right now thinks he's on round 6. And when he teleports back, you see it says plus 200 survive. That means the game thinks he ended the round again. Now the game actually thinks he's on round 7, but in reality, he's actually on round 5 still. Now Ganon's goal is to do this as much as he can, so when the zombies spawn in, they spawn super fast on such low rounds. He doesn't want to do it too much, so you saw Ganon went on round 5. Ganon is going to go every 3 rounds to Pack-a-Punch. The reason he has to go every 3 rounds is because there's a cooldown on the Pack-a-Punch, so he can't just go every round or every 2 rounds. He has to wait every 3 rounds to be as fast as he can, but also wait for that fence to go down by the Pack-a-Punch. Now Ganon is on round 17, but the game actually thinks he's on round 25 because he went to power 4 times, so the game actually thinks he progressed 8 rounds. This only changes for the spawn rate of the zombies. So the damage is going to be the same and everything else is going to be the same, but the zombies are going to spawn in as if it's round 25. This is a very, very crucial to the point of if you want to actually be fast on this map. If you want to be Ganon Snipes, you have to go to Pack-a-Punch as much as you can without being slow. So theoretically, if you want, you could try going on round 20 and see how fast that goes for you. But with all the testing I'm assuming Ganon has done, he knows for a fact the fastest you can be is by going and the last time being on round 17. Now from here on out, all Ganon is doing is literally just shooting. He's using his Gobblegums and just shooting, shooting, shooting. He's not going to be turning on power at all this whole entire speedrun. So that means he's not going to be able to hack the drops at all. Now, what Gobblegums is Ganon using? On Moon, usually you'd use License Contractor, Fire Sales, because those things you can hack, you know, 3 fire sales that equals 3 max ammos on Moon. But if you don't have power on, then what Golems are you going to be using? Well, Ganon is using Killjoys. Killjoys are going to help you, obviously, kill zombies. They give you a whole entire minute of insta-kills. Not only that, they'll help you force drops when needed. Obviously, you get 4 drops every round, and since he doesn't have power on, he has a perfect drop cycle, which means he has a possibility to get a max ammo every single round. No matter when he gets his max, you'll have a possibility to get a max ammo drop. Now, of course, for max ammos, Ganon is also using the Gobblegum Cashback. He's also using Alchemical, and he's also using Raindrop. All 3 of these Gobblegums are going to help him get max ammos directly. Obviously, Alchem giving you 2 minutes of infinite ammo, and then also 2 free max ammos, and then Raindrop's giving you 2 free max ammos, and then obviously Cashback just giving you 1 free max ammo. Along with those 4 Gobblegums, Ganon's last one is Fatal Contraptions, doing a very similar effect to Killjoys, but on a lower scale. Since death machines actually go down in damage as the rounds progress, it'll be harder to kill zombies. So what Ganon is doing is cycling his gums as much as he can to make sure he only gets his max ammos in his gumballs and not really picking up his Killjoys and Fatals. When he's on such an early round like round 20, he's obviously not going to have to worry about that at all. But when he's on later rounds, like round 90 or like 95, he's definitely going to be wanting only max ammo Gobblegums. And if needed, he'll be double hitting the Gobblegum machine. And every time the round ends, all Ganon does is just runs all the way down over here. He goes here, blah, blah, blah. It's the Gobblegum machine. If it's Gobblegum he wants, he picks it up. If it's Gobblegum he doesn't want, he doesn't pick it up. He does breach just a tad bit. It is usually okay. Now, very similar to the Kino Totoan video I made last week. If you guys haven't checked that out, make sure you check it out, link in the description. All Ganon is doing on this strat is just shooting, 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 and shooting. There's really nothing else Ganon has to worry about. I guess for the astronaut, but Ganon Snipes has AETs, if you guys don't know. Deadwire, Blast Furnace, and Thunderwall destroy the astronaut with a single proc. Ganon Snipes is totally doesn't have to worry about the astronaut at all. He obviously doesn't have power on because of the excavators. All Ganon is doing is literally just grabbing his alchems, going back to the strat, and just shooting with his wave gun over and over and over again. If need be, he'll throw Gersh's 4 drops, but other than that, literally all he does is shoot. Now, obviously, worst comes to worst, Ganon does have to throw Gersh's just a little bit. He obviously hopes for a drop, but if he can't get drops, he'll just pop his cash back here. The Moon high round is super simple, especially to round 100. If you guys want an easy round 100, I really would suggest Moon. There's nothing gets easier than Moon. Like, Ganon isn't using power here, but if he was using power, he'd be able to hack every single Gobblegum he gets. So, if you want a free round 100, just turn on power on Moon, hack every single drop you get, and you'll be totally fine to round 100. You'll just see he's trying to kill as many zombies as he possibly can. He lets all the zombies jump onto the barrier. He gets hit a little bit even, and as soon as he can, he shoots. And compared to the Kino Totoan video I made, Moon does not have any dog round, and Moon is actually 11 minutes faster than the Kino Totoan video I did make. So without dog rounds, meaning he is only killing zombies, no dogs are involved at all in the speedrun. Compared to the Kino video where you have a dog round every 4 to 5 rounds, Ganon was still 11 minutes faster. That really shows you how fast Moon is. Imagine if you added dog rounds to Moon. Moon might even be a sub 2-hour round 100 speedrun, but there's no dogs. All you're doing is shooting zombies over and over and over again. There's literally nothing in between. So all he does is just shoots, shoots, shoots. And in what probably is not only the fastest round 100 speedrun ever on Black Ops 3, he probably also achieved the fastest round 99 with a 3 minute and 17 second round 99 length. Ganon Snipes got a 2-hour, 33 minutes, and 5 second round 100 speedrun on Moon, beating out second place by a total of 3 minutes, which may or may not have been me. Fuck you, Ganon. Anyways, I did hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please make sure you guys leave a like. Comment what other videos you guys want me to make. I know I already made a Kino Round 100 video. If you guys want to see something else along these lines, I know you guys have been loving these videos. So if you guys do want to see other stuff like this, please comment. Tell me what you guys want to see. I do hope you enjoyed. Please share, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you guys in the next one.